pencil set here. I'm actually on the way to the gym right now. I'm about to leave, so I thought it would be perfect to bring you guys with me and show you guys my workout routine. I'm actually on a weight gain journey. I have never been over 100 pounds in my entire life until this year. I started at around 95 pounds. And now I'm about 108, 109. That's almost 15 pounds that I've gained. And you know what's crazy? I actually went from a size 000 to a size 1. And I had to get all brand new jeans. I'm really trying to focus on the legs and the butt and the abs, you know, get the stomach flat, get the booty popping, get the legs bigger, you know. When you're just someone who's small and you're trying to put on size, you have to be taking in a lot of calories. So am I telling you to eat McDonald's every day? No, you shouldn't be eating food that's bad for you, but you should be eating food that is healthy or as healthy as you can make it, and you should be taking in a lot of calories. I decided to get a personal trainer. I'm going to show you guys our typical sort of like leg and butt workout that we do, and I decided to get a trainer just because the gym for me was really scary. It was really, really scary. It was intimidating. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't. Gaining weight is very, very hard, and it's also very offensive when you make comments to people telling them to eat. This video was actually really hard for me to post just because I am insecure about my weight, so if you guys would just please, let's keep things positive in the comments. Thanks. But yeah, I want to show you guys my workout routine, what I've been doing. I'm really, really proud of myself. I'm stronger, I have made improvements, and I just feel better about my body, and that's really all that matters, is how I feel, and you guys have been seeing my progress, so I wanted to show you guys and have you come along with me, so let's go. I'm finally at the gym. I'm here with my trainer, Josh.
How you doing? It's Joshua Hope with NJ Hope We Trust. Today, we're gonna go over a basic routine for Lissette's leg. Let's get it.
Before we get started, though, I have a question for you. What are your top three tips? Or like little tips to gain weight. What does someone need to do? Top three.
Top three? Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm gonna go in order. Number one, eat more, increase your calorie intake. Number two, you definitely wanna work out with weights, so throw weights in your routine. If you're just doing body weight training, throw some weight training in there. And number three, my number three, would be drink water, so properly hydrating, and then along with less stress. Don't stress. Stress can lead to weight loss.
How many meals should people have? Is it like big meals, or is it like small meals, or is it like every 2 hours snacks? Like, how does that?
You want to have at least 6 to 8 meals a day. Three of those meals, whatever you consider big, three of those meals needs to be your hefty meals. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, and the other 3 to 4 should be snacks, maybe a banana, PB&J sandwich, or just a bag of 100 calorie chips, just something light. Or fruits. Fruits are good. Good sugars.
Yeah.
It's lit.
We ready?
It's lit!
Let's go. So starting with the warm-up, he has me do fire hydrants. So it's 3 sets of 10 each leg. This helps to just warm up and work out your hips and the butt area. Here I'm just doing them to the side, but you can actually rotate your leg forward and backward. So next, I'm doing reverse single leg raises. So I'm just going to raise my leg up. I'm trying to squeeze my butt when I get to the top. So I'm doing 3 sets of 10 for each leg on this. So next is abs. Basically what we do is just switch from exercise to exercise. So we're doing 10 seconds of ab swings, 10 seconds of scissors, and then 10 seconds of leg flutters. And once that's done, we repeat and do 3 sets. You can add more like different ab exercises, but we decided just to do these 3 today just to show you guys, because these are the most simple in my opinion and the ones that I can do the best, because abs will be the death of me. Next, we're doing squats, the trusty old squat. We're doing 3 sets of 15, and I have my hands out just to help with balance and just, you know, keep my posture right. So I'm trying to get as low as possible. And once I get up to the top, I'm making sure to squeeze my butt, even though it's not cute. I guess that's what you need to do. That's what my trainer always tells me to squeeze. So that's what I'm doing.
Another variation of the squat, we have squat jumps. We're doing 3 sets of 15. This is just like a squat, except when you get in the squat position, you just want to push yourself up just so that you can really work out your legs, work out your thighs. I have a love-hate relationship with lunges. I love them because I feel the burn, but I hate them because I feel the burn. So basically, I'm just doing walking lunges. This is 15 feet, so up and down, which is 30 feet, is one set. So I'm doing that 3 times. These are RDLs. I am not that flexible, but ideally you want to get as low as you can. This is as low as I can go. So I'm just bending over and I'm squeezing when I get to the top. And for these, I'm doing 3 sets of 12. This is helping to work out your hamstrings and to really stretch them out. And I also have 15 pound weights.
Good, you got 3 more. Squeeze, good. Squeeze, 1 more. Good, relax.
Big 90 pounds.
90?
Big girl weight.
Ooh. All right, let's do it.
So this machine, I guess it's called the V-squat machine, and it's kind of awkward and weird feeling, but basically I am squatting with 90 pounds, 3 sets of 12, and when I first started using this machine, I believe I was doing 30 pounds. Now I'm up to 90, and I can even go up to 110 on good days, but today I just decided to do 90. So I'm just squatting and making sure to focus on my breathing and trying to keep a steady pace. This is the hip abduction machine. I'm doing 3 sets of 12. It's on, I believe, like 40, 45 pounds. I'm basically just like opening and closing my legs. And what you can do is actually hold it when you get on the outside. You can hold it for like a few seconds just so you can feel the burn a little bit more. So as he said, we're gonna be doing some stretches. This is just like the basic stretch. You wanna have your feet together, you wanna bend at the hips and just see as far as you can go, but you can really feel, you know, your hamstrings, the back of your legs, the back of your calves, just stretching out. One of my goals is to get more flexible, so stretching for me is really important. So this is one I've never done, so I was kind of like, what? But basically, you just want to, I guess, sit back on your heels a little bit. This is another stretch that you can do that helps to stretch your legs. And this one was actually really burning because I just worked out my thighs. And this is the last stretch. This is the position that you want to be in. And you basically just want to try to touch your nose to your knee.
Take fitness serious. Your health is very important.
All right, guys, so we just finished the workout. I'm feeling good.
Ready to take on the world.
Ready?
Stretching.
If you like this video and you would like to see more fitness videos from me, then please make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.